Much of the technology that threatens our freedom and our dignity in the near-term future is being developed by companies in the business of capturing and selling our data and our attention to advertisers and others. Facebook, Google, Amazon. And many of these ad finance platforms, they boast that they're free. In this context, it means that we are the product that's being sold. Think of all the data that Facebook has on you. Every status update you ever typed, every messenger conversation, every place you logged in from, all your photographs that you uploaded there. If you start typing something and change your mind and delete it, Facebook keeps those and analyzes them too. Increasingly, it tries to match you with your offline data. It also purchases a lot of data from data brokers. It could be everything from your financial records to a good chunk of your browsing history. They also encourage deep surveillance on all of us so that the machine learning algorithms can work. That's why Facebook wants to collect all the data it can about you. The algorithms work better. These algorithms can quite easily infer things like your ethnicity, religious and political views, personality traits, intelligence, happiness, use of addictive substances, parental separation, age, and genders, just from Facebook likes. These algorithms can identify protesters even if their faces are partially concealed. These algorithms may be able to detect people's sexual orientation just from their dating profile pictures. If the people in power are using these algorithms to quietly watch us, to judge us, and to nudge us, and to manipulate individuals one by one using their personal individual weaknesses and vulnerabilities, and if they're doing it at scale, through our private screens, that authoritarianism will envelop us like a spider's web. And we may not even know we're in it. We need a digital economy where our data and our attention is not for sale to the highest bidding authoritarian or demagogue.